In this lesson, we'll take a look at several examples of interpreting the meaning of the area under a curve. So for this example, we want to interpret the area of this blue shaded region. The key to doing these types of problems is identifying the units on the x and y axis. Notice the x axis represents the time in hours, and the y axis represents the number of kilowatts used per hour. And it may be helpful to represent a slice of this area with a rectangle, maybe something like this. And then to determine the area of this rectangle, we have to multiply the width times the height, where the width represents the time in hours and the height represents the kilowatts used per hour. So to do these types of problems, we need to interpret what it means when we multiply time in hours times kilowatts used per hour. So in this case, the entire shaded region represents the number of kilowatts used over this time period of 8 hours. Notice how the usage per hour does vary. It starts low, increases, and then decreases, but the area represents the total kilowatts used over this time period. For the second example, notice that the x-axis represents time in hours again, but now the y-axis represents the velocity in miles per hour. So again, if it's helpful, we can take a slice of this area, and then to determine the area of this rectangle, we have to multiply the width, or the time in hours, times the height, which would be the velocity in miles per hour. So we need to interpret the meaning behind multiplying the time in hours by the velocity in miles per hour. Well, velocity is a rate. When we multiply rate and time, we actually get distance. So this orange shaded region represents the total distance traveled over 4 hours. This should remind us of the formula distance equals rate times time, where the y-axis is the velocity or the rate, and the x-axis is the time in hours. Let's take a look at one more example. The x-axis represents the number of days, and the y-axis represents the revenue per day. So we could sketch a rectangle that represents a piece of this area to help us interpret the meaning of the total area. To determine the area of this rectangle, we'd multiply the width, which represents the number of days, times the height, which represents the revenue per day. Well, if we multiply the number of days times the revenue per day, the result would be the total revenue over that time period. So this green area represents the total revenue generated over 20 days. So the key to doing these types of problems is interpreting the meaning behind multiplying the units on the x-axis by the units on the y-axis. I hope this was helpful.